Hi there, Heather Pillow here. I am a senior executive director with Pure Romance, and today I'm going to share with you how to utilize your social media and going live to help increase both your exposure for your business and broaden your circle of influence, as well as increase your sales. So, I know it can be really super nerve-wracking when you think about, okay, I'm going to hit that button and go live, and who knows who's going to watch me? Maybe they'll watch me, maybe they won't. Maybe they'll interact, maybe they won't. Maybe I'll say something. Maybe I have something stuck in my teeth. And you just overthink it ad nauseum, right? You're just constantly thinking about all the things that can go wrong. The good news is a couple of things. One, nobody is perfect and alive. It's just the way that it is. It's why it's interesting because we are being ourselves, theoretically. Two, you can always hit the delete button, you guys. Just end it, delete, and only the people who are ever on there ever see it. And generally, it's not going to be thousands and thousands of people, so I think you're safe. So don't worry about that. Here's a couple of tips that I have for you, okay? So this is not only great for you, this is great for you to teach to your team, but in order for you to teach it to your team, you're going to need to get comfortable yourself. So the very first thing that I want you to do is I want you to go onto your personal Facebook page and go in to a post and change the setting so that it says only me, not public. Not only friends, friends of friends, only me. So when you go live, you will be the only person that can see it unless you tag somebody in it. And I want you to go in and hit the buttons. Hit all the buttons, do all the things and make the mistakes. Flip your camera around, try side by side, do different things so that you can see how it works before anyone else sees you. And do it a couple of times, right? Like get comfortable with it. Find lighting that's good for you. Find a background that makes you feel comfortable. You definitely want to try and make sure that unless you're talking about your kids or your pets, that you have some quiet space to be able to do this so that they can hear you well. Normally, I love to record outside, and today is super, super windy. And not only would my hair be all up in my face, but the wind actually picks up on the microphone, so it's really loud. So just be aware of your surroundings when you decide to go live. Now, I don't ever go live unscripted. Like it's pretty unusual for me to do that. I at least have a post-it note stuck to the bottom of my phone or my laptop with bullet points. So I make sure that I hit the high points of whatever the topic is that I want to talk about. And you can go live about literally anything. You can go live about the subscription box that you just got. You can go live about the meal that you're making. Show them how you make your favorite summer salad. You can go live about literally anything. But for the purpose of our business, I encourage you to go live about our products. We have a huge product line, way more than you could possibly ever show at any party. And even if you have repeat clients, chances are they're not going to see the entire product line. So you have the opportunity to really expose them to some great products that you may not show at a live party. So here's my recommendation for you. And I recommend that you do this not only for yourself, but then pass it along to your team so that they can use it as well. I want you to write out a script. Write it out. If you're a technology person, then go ahead and type it out. Generally, I write mine and then I go ahead and I transfer it into my laptop because I tend to write like I talk. And that's how I want to be heard by the people that are listening to me. I want it to feel authentic to me. Now, it's important that you understand that a script isn't going to be verbatim. It's going to be, again, bullet points, high notes, especially when you're talking about products. You may have some ingredients in there, flavor options, those kinds of things. But ultimately, it's not just about the product. It's about you. They want to see you and your personality. So I like to start off my live with a big welcome. Hey, everybody. Happy hump day, whatever's happening, blah, blah. Where are you? I like to know where they're watching from, not just city and state, but like, are you in a cube land somewhere? Are you riding down the road and somebody's driving and you're playing on Facebook? What are you doing and where are you that you're watching me? And that also allows for a little bit of time for people to get on the live, right? It sends out a notification, Heather Pillow has gone live, and then it takes a couple of minutes for people to get that notification and click on it. What you don't want to do is go live and be like, okay, so we're going to hang out for a second and wait for some folks to join us. They're gone. They're gone instantaneously. They will leave and they won't come back because it was not interesting. They want something right now. So I love to go live with a prop. So you could be holding up your product, right? Immediately. So the very first thing that they see, even if you haven't talked about it, is, Hey, we're back with Product Highlights with Heather, and today we're going to be talking about this product. Tell me where you're watching from. Now, while they're telling me where they're watching from, I'm hitting the little button down below. It looks like the silhouette of a person with a plus sign, and that pops up all your friends. And you can literally go through and go invite, 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 invite. Don't even worry about who you're clicking. Just invite, 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 invite. Do at least 20 of them. And it will automatically send another notification that not only says that Heather Pillow's gone live, but Heather Pillow has invited you to watch her live. So it individually invites those people that you invite. But again, you got to be careful about making sure you're still engaged, trying to watch the little comments. Hey, how are you? Popping up. Acknowledge everybody that's popping in, at least in the first couple of minutes, so they can see you. Hey, how are you? How are your kids? Congratulations on graduation. Blah, blah, blah. You don't want to do it for too long, and you do want to keep it interesting. Some other things that I did, like I went live the day of my daughter's graduation about a product, but I wore her cap, her mortarboard, in my video. A vast majority of people actually scroll through their newsfeed silently, so they're not hearing anything. So you need to look interesting, fun, weird, bizarre, something to kind of catch their eye and make them go, wait, what is she talking about? And actually hit it so that they hear the sound. Now, the other thing you want to think about before you go live is, what is your caption going to be? And the good news is you can actually go back in after the fact and edit your caption. But ideally, think through your caption and make sure that the first two lines in particular really grab their attention. It doesn't have to be, you know, product highlight. Let's say that you're showing Miracle Oil. Are you sunburned? Me too. Check this out. And that's it. Like, clearly Miracle Oil does many more things than help with sunburn, but it's very relatable right now because it's pool season, beach season, everybody's outside, and they're like, oh, me too. Let's hit that. So you want to make sure that you're really pulling them in. And then you're going to start talking, okay? So you welcome them. Hey, thanks for watching, blah, blah. Super excited about this. Weather's beautiful today. Love it. And then you're going to say, listen, so you know that I love to go live and share with you about things that I use in my day-to-day life that you may never get the opportunity to see. And today I want to talk to you about Miracle Oil. And then you're just going to start talking about it. That is where your script comes in. So I like to have it kind of propped right below me, tape it to your phone, whatever, so that you can like naturally kind of glance down and keep track of things, but you're not necessarily reading from the script. Now, here's what I'll tell you. When it comes to products that have like really specific ingredients, like our essential oils, it is 100% okay for you to be like, I'm going to refer to my notes because I want to make sure I get this right. And you read exactly what's in it. It's better to be correct than it is to be perfectly polished. Because again, they're seeing you, they want to see your personality. Don't worry too much about the, oh my gosh, I messed that up or I misspoke or whatever. Move on. You guys really and truly, like, I promise you it's fine. They're not noticing. Most of the time, you're the only one that's even remotely aware that you flubbed something. So just keep going. And if it's really a big flub, make fun of it. Own it. Laugh at yourself. It makes you relatable. Everybody does it. My clients love to tease me that they never know what's going to come out of my mouth. And it's because I don't know what's going to come out of my mouth. Like, I roll with it. Whatever's near me, I might pull something up or grab glasses or whatever. So let your natural personality come through. Now, when you're talking about a product, it's just like when you're at a party. You want to paint a picture before you launch into all of the details of the product. So again, using the Miracle Oil example, talk about all of the things that go on with skin on all different types of people that might help. Not only is this amazing for sunburn, but y'all, if you have kids in your house, if you've got babies with cradle cap, if you've got kids that are outside, they love to be outside, but the mosquitoes love them even more. Bug bites, bee stings, skin knees, all of those things. So go through and learn your product. Really figure it out. Now, where do you find this information? The best news is that the vast majority of what you're ever going to need is actually on COO. In fact, a lot of it is on your personal website. If you go in and you pull it up just like a client would and click on information, it's going to have ingredient lists. It's going to have ways that you can use it. So just take that. That is exactly what it's there for you to be able to not only share it, but for your clients to understand it as well. And when it comes from corporate, you know it's spot on. So don't be afraid to use the tools that are available to you. So you're going to explain, and when people pop in and they're like, I love it. I love Miracle Oil. Or if you see somebody 5 minutes into your video and you're like, Becky, oh my God, watching from South Africa, so fun. It's okay to have a little splash of ADD when you're doing this stuff. Like, again, it's just like when you're at a party and you're interacting, you're not completely laser focused on the one person in front of you and completely ignoring everyone around you. You're being social. And that's exactly what this is. It's social networking, right? So you want to make sure that you're as social as humanly possible on your videos. Now, here's the kicker, okay? We don't ever talk money in this video. I am never going to go live and be like, Miracle Oil costs $20, but I have a deal and here it is. I don't do that. I don't even tell them how much it is. Even when they ask, I just ignore that until the end of my video when I say, okay, so this is our featured product of the day or the week or however often you're doing it. And I have a deal for you, but it's so hot, I'm not allowed to share it on my personal page. So all you're gonna need to do is hit Heather Pillow and it can private message me and I will tell you all the details about everything you could possibly want and I'm gonna cut you a great deal. And I only have 7 deals today. So I limit the number of deals that I have as far as they're concerned. Am I ever gonna limit it unless it's discontinued and gone? No, I will absolutely give it to them and share everything they could possibly want to know and make sure that they get the deal. But it does create a sense of urgency so that they're not like, oh, I'll be back after baseball practice and blah, 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 blah. Like, we want them to message you right now and then thank them for watching. If you already have your next live planned, tell them when it is and what's going to happen on it and thank them for watching and you're done. And that's it. Great lives are generally less than about 10 minutes. Because again, people are busy and if they see before they even start watching that it's 25, 30 minutes, an hour long, unless it is a really compelling topic, they aren't even going to start it. So keep them short, but give it enough time to get some people on there. And remember, lots of people watch after the fact. So don't sweat the fact that it says 3 people are watching you live. First of all, that's not an accurate number because people who are not your friends will not count in that number. So if you have strangers that just happen to see because you went publicly live, they're watching you and you have no idea. And that's great. This is how you increase your exposure. So you're going to go back after you turn off your live feed. Make sure I always save my videos to my phone in case anything goes wrong. Then I know that I can at least upload the video because you spent time and energy making it. You want to make sure it's really good, right? And that you get to keep it. And then you can also upload it like to YouTube or wherever else it is that you're advertising your business. But then you wanna go back to the comments and comment on everybody who comment. Thanks so much for watching. Hey girl, if you wanna try this, private message me. Thanks for the shout out. I'm so glad you love the product. By the way, your baby looked adorable at baptism. Like all the interaction, because that's gonna show Facebook, not only did people watch when it was live, but they're still interacting right now. And then I go back in and I post before and after pictures in the comments. I might post the link to my website. You can do all kinds of things in the comments to keep it rolling, but don't just disregard the video once it's done. It can absolutely be used again. And the best news is that it can then be shared. So if you click on your own video and it starts talking, and I know it's annoying because you see yourself and you're like, my voice sounds so weird. Everybody thinks that, it's fine, just let it go. Down in the corner, you're gonna see share. Hit that button and it will allow you to copy that link and you can then repost that video anywhere, which is why it's really good to do it publicly if you can on your page, because then there's no limitations to who can see it. If you record the video where only friends can see it and you post it in a group where you've got people that aren't friends, they won't be able to see it. It'll be a dead link. So public videos are great. Couple of quick reminders. Remember that we are never allowed to go live with bedroom accessories on our personal page. That's always in a private, secret, or closed group. You can refer to it in a video and say, hey, by the way, tomorrow I'm gonna be going live in my VIP lounge because it's gonna be a little more adult and I'm not gonna be doing that on my public page, and just let them know. But make sure that your videos are always tasteful. Make sure that you aren't cursing. You wanna really represent not only your own business, but the company very professionally. And again, if it just goes sideways and you're not happy with it, hit that delete button, start over again, but share the ideas that you're using with other consultants Don't worry about, oh, I don't want them to do it just like me. I can assure you they're not going to do it like you. I can hand every single one of you this exact same script, and every one of your videos is going to have a different vibe and different content because you're just naturally going to talk. So don't worry about that. Share the wealth. It all comes back to you. And if you have questions, you are welcome to reach out to me. Again, my name is Heather Pillow, and I appreciate you watching. Have an awesome day and happy sales.